Hi, welcome back to my workshop. As you know, I'm building a CNC machine from a 3D printer. I suggest you watch previous parts first if you haven't already. I'm planning on getting the machine ready to cut stuff ASAP. So the plan is to finish the X-axis first and then tackle the electronics. That way I'm hoping to do the first cuts soon and see how the machine performs. Then I will deal with the way covers, enclosure, possible upgrades and things to modify to get the results I'm hoping for. So, let's get to work. For the table of the machine, I had a piece of aluminum that looked like a piece of Swiss cheese. It had a bunch of holes from where it was used, but it was 20 mm thick and when cut to size, it fit perfectly for the table of my CNC. I do not have a bandsaw, so I had to mill out the size I wanted from the whole piece. It was a bit of a tedious task, but no end mills were broken during the process. I used some cutting oil to lubricate the cut. The plate I got out was perfect in size, but I wanted a clean surface without holes. I decided to buy a plate of precision milled aluminum that I got for the price of offcuts. It was 10 mm thick and the plan was to epoxy glue it to the main plate as a fresh top surface. I bought some metal epoxy from Hobby King for a very cheap price and glued the fresh plate to the old one. The main process with gluing was of course the preparation. I set up the table in the garage and prepared everything I needed. For spreading the glue, I 3D printed the spatula with a wavy pattern to spread the glue evenly. I first tried to sand both surfaces by hand, but the electric sander did a much better and faster job at roughing the surface for better adhesion. I then proceeded with mixing the epoxy and then spread it evenly on the plate without holes. I fitted the two new plates so they were covering the whole bottom plate and then weighted the whole setup down with heavy items that I could find. By the way, this is the headstock of an Emco lathe for the next project. Hit like button to support me and see how I finish this one and tackle the other projects. There's a lot more content coming. I clamped the part first with the help of superglue technique that I already utilized in the previous video, so I had access to the whole top surface. The very important part was to press down the painter's tape with the dowel pin so the holding force was much higher. It was also important to clean the surfaces with isopropyl alcohol or acetone. I then proceeded with milling the top surface with DIY fly cutter so I got nice finish. Then I trimmed the outside edges with the end mill and I also added some clamps to better hold down the part since they were not in the way anymore. The dimensions were not critical, so I only went for a nice finish. So, now we have a top surface done. I already had the part in the mill, so I decided to solve another problem with future fixturing on that table. I wanted something similar to T-slot profiles that are common for the milling machines, but that would reduce the thickness of the table and make it less rigid. The other concern was that the force of the T-nuts would start to separate the top glued plate from the main plate. So, I decided to make a grid pattern of M6 holes on the whole plate, similar to Saunders Machine Works fixture plate, although I did not add a precision rimmed feature for the precise positioning on the plate. I only had to figure out the pattern spacing, which was really tricky. I was deciding between 40mm or 30mm spacing. Closer spacing is great, but the number of holes to be drilled and tapped was enormous. I went with the 30mm pattern anyway. I only spotted the holes on the milling machine because drilling them was much faster on the drill press. I also drilled the holes for bolting the bearing blocks and bolt screw nut block. The dimensions were very critical, so I took a lot of care calculating them. As you can see, some of the holes intercepted the fixturing holes, but that was no big deal since they have a higher priority. I later tapped the fixturing holes for M6 with a cordless drill. So, the upper side of the plate was finished. On the bottom, I only had to machine two flat tracks for mounting the bearing blocks and one pocket for ball screw nut block. I also had to machine a clearance in the middle to clear the fixed bearing of the ball screw. Everything was pretty straightforward, the only critical dimension was the height of the bearing blocks with regard to height of the ball screw. That's it for this video. In the next one, I will finish mounting the CNC table and resolve the problem with mounting the X-axis motor for the table. Thank you very much for watching. Please subscribe and I will see you in the next one. Bye!